I think it's safe to say that Black Ops 3 was a pretty big success. It surprisingly brought a lot of people to the jetpack era without resistance. Now, Treyarch has been criticized in recent years for their map design, but Black Ops 3 had a pretty solid offering. And today, well, today, I want to remind you guys just how good a lot of the maps were in this game. Welcome to the top three series where we cheat, we cut to the front of the line, and we're going to go over the three best maps from Black Ops 3. Let me know your top three list or which map was your favorite. Drop a like, turn on your notifications, make sure you're following the page, share it with a fellow Black Ops 3 teammate, and let's start off with Breach. It was a medium-sized map that complemented every playstyle. That's part of what made it so good. You had the snipers, they would go at each other in the middle lane. You had the rushers who would flank from the sides, and you had the people with massive, well, you know what, who would run into the middle hut and try to get the drop on the other team in the fastest way possible. Then you had the two buildings on each side of the map where massive fights would go down. Breach may have been a pretty standard map in terms of the layout, but the verticality and the spacing, it made it fun. The only downside, there was a downside, was the fact that a lot of it was indoors, meaning a lot of the killstreaks were unviable here, which could get frustrating if you were going on a long streak, you got a Wraith or a Mothership and only got 2 to 3 kills with them because the entire enemy was sitting inside, but Breach was solid. Next up is Fringe, Sniper's Paradise. If you boot up Black Ops 3 right now, go ahead, go boot it up while you're listening to me. Get a game, get on Fringe, I guarantee you, at least half the lobby will have a sniper rifle. It was a medium-sized map with a ton of open sight lines and the entire middle lane was exposed. It allowed people to either hide in the windows and snipe each other or just jetpack out and try to take everybody on head-on. If you don't want to snipe, there's some options. I mean, you still go down the side lanes, completely covered from the middle snipers. You could play stealthy, sneak around, punish all the snipers who weren't paying attention. Fringe may not have been the fastest map in Black Ops 3, but people loved it for how strong the sniping was. Unlike Breach, killstreaks were devastating here. And at number one today, Combine. You probably expected it. It's not a shocker. It was the go-to map for high kill games in BO3, and while it was a tad overplayed, it was never skipped. Never. A traditional Treyarch three-lane map with a little bit of verticality and a little bit of wall running to complement the movement of Black Ops 3. Now, pretty much every playstyle is viable here. If you're going to go for a great YouTube gameplay, this map was it. If you managed to get a Wraith or a Cerberus on this map, all you had to do was plop them down in the middle and watch them go to work. And if you somehow managed to get the wraps here, well, there you go. There's another 25. I mean, Combine was a ton of fun, and it provided that classic fast-paced Treyarch gameplay despite being in a game with jetpacks. I think if Treyarch was to bring Combine back in Black Ops Cold War, it would still play pretty well. Yes, they'd have to put a floor on that wall run side, but on the other than that, I think it would work well. It's a great map, and I think it's the best Black Ops 3 had to offer. You guys let me know where you agree or disagree, and I'll see you soon.